If you've ever watched any HGTV, you know that barndominiums, or barndos, are actually growing in popularity. Over the past 10 years, people have either been building their own barndos or rehabbing existing barns into barndominiums. In this episode of Foam University, I'm going to explain to you why they're so popular and how you can use foam insulation like RetroFoam to insulate one. We're on location here at a RetroFoam install in the walls of this existing barndominium. As you can see behind me, there is a lot of action. One person is drilling holes into the sheathing, as a foreman behind him is going through and filling those walls with RetroFoam. Another crew member is checking the wall cavities to make sure there's not any kind of fire stops or blockages that may require them to drill another hole into the wall cavity to make sure that they're above or below that stop. Just like with any RetroFoam install project, as the foreman is going through and injecting the foam, another crew member is falling behind them and plugging those holes with styrofoam plugs. After that's done, they go through and clean up and they make sure to tape the plastic back to the sheathing and replace the siding that was removed as part of the install process. Now, the interesting thing about the wall construction in this particular barndominium is that instead of there being separate wall cavities throughout this wall, in actuality, this is one big open cavity. So the foreman needs to go through and make sure that he's able to fill it from the top to the bottom. Still has the holes in a line across the wall just to make sure that it's completely filled. But with it being a completely open cavity, that does add some complication to the install that the foreman has already discussed with his crew to make sure that they can completely fill it. Part of the appeal of a barndominium is going to be these big, open, spacious walls and ceilings. At this particular one, the walls aren't incredibly tall, but the way that they're injecting, as you can see, as I mentioned before, is that they're drilling holes at the top and the bottom, sometimes in the middle, because there's stops in the wall, so we want to make sure they completely fill that cavity. If you have a barndominium where the walls are significantly taller, you'll have to talk to your contractor because it may affect the way the RetroFoam is installed. You see these great big doors behind me? Foam insulation is actually a great product for those too. Now, obviously you're not going to use injection foam, but spray foam is an option. You can use either open cell or closed cell. Closed cell is usually a really good fit for these doors just for the simple fact that it doesn't have an expansion ring. One thing to keep in mind about that closed cell spray foam is that it's very dense and doesn't move with the door. So each panel of the door would have to be sprayed. In some cases, open cell might be a better fit. So what makes barndominiums so popular? Well, there's a lot of things that go into that. First of all, barndominiums tend to be more energy efficient. One, just because the process of actually building a barndominium doesn't take as long as a traditional home because it's built much like the best way to compare it is going to be to like a pole barn. Many barndominiums are built with metal structures. The framing is metal, the sheathing's metal, and then they turn it into a home from there. Now, this particular barndominium that we're working on today is made from wood. So the structure itself is wood, the sheathing is wood. Another thing that people like about barndominiums is that they're big, wide open floor plans. You can go in and it is like a blank canvas and they can turn that into whatever they want their home to be. They're big, they're energy efficient because of the way that they're built and the amount of time that it takes to build them, and they're more sustainable. The draw of a barndominium is going to be that it doesn't need the same kind of maintenance that a traditional home has. Because many of them are made of steel, that makes them more durable. They last longer. You don't have to worry about things like wood rot. Another thing that you don't have to worry about with a steel barndominium is going to be pests. Things like termites or other pests that can destroy the wood. If your structure is metal, that's something you're going to want to discuss with your contractor before your project begins. If you're in the process of building your barndominium, you would talk to your insulation contractor. In that case, you would likely use spray foam before the drywall is put up. Now, many of these are existing structures that we've been working with, so then that's when RetroFoam comes into play and it is a great fit for this installation. I've explained to you how to insulate a barndominium with RetroFoam, but let's talk a little bit about why. RetroFoam and spray foam insulation both create an air barrier or an air seal in the home, completely sealing this building envelope. Now, if you're choosing a barndominium because you want a more energy efficient space and a more sustainable space, then foam insulation is going to be the absolute best option for you. Now, if you're ready to build the barndominium of your dreams, barndominiums, or you're getting ready to rehab a barndominium, you're likely going to need insulation. And if that's the case, check out the Find a Dealer page on our website. There you're going to find RetroFoam dealers across the country who can help your barndominium be as comfortable as you always hoped it could be. I'm your building science brainiac, reminding you to bring a little science to every project.